Vande Guru Padodandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nitta Ananda Sauditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Vande Radhika Charanodayam Gopi Jano Samayuktam Vrindavanam Manoharam Vāñcākalpataruvascha kipāsindhu bevacha patitānaṁ pāvune bhavaiṣṇavebhyo namo namah mūkhaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgum laṅghaiti giram yat kipātam aham vande paramānanda mādhavam vṛndāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasacha Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Satva Vattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naruncaiva Narottam Deving Swaraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Dira Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadesha Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramadakcha Jagodvarun Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Vishtaduham Tithasvadam Sivavirunchanatam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panatopal Bhavadipotam Bande Mahapurushate Charanarvindam Yat pad pallavanaka chandamani chatai Bispurjita kimapigopavodhu shvadarshi Purna nuragra sasagra saramurti Saradhikamai kadakifam kakrosi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Vinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Vinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Ajanulambita Bhujau Kanuka Badato Sankirtanai Kapitaru Kamala Yotaksho Vishambaro Dijavaro Jugadharma Palo Bande Jagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhutaru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chadada Sinitam Bhavanurupe Nasada Naranam Ganga Taranga Ramaniya Jata Kalapam Gauri Nirantara Vibhushi Tobam Bhagam Narayano Priyamananga Madapharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Vagi Shajasya Badane Lakshmir Jashacha Vakshashi Yasasthi Hide Sambi Vam Shingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Balavan adar jasana sat guru padam bhaje sutoi rasta sutoi rapitasya sasastra krishne bhakti na jayate balavan indriyagram na sat guru padam bhaje sutoi rapitasya sasastra krishne bhakti na jayate Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Gauriya Goshtipati told that bonded soul by no means can attain mangal. Bonded soul by his own effort, personal effort, can never attain mangal, actual mangal. But very often Srila Saraswati Pad, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada used to say that we will have to totally adjust it with Rupanuga Guru Bharga. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada used to speak very often that we will have to get totally adjusted with our Rupanuga Guru Bharga. Prabhupada used to speak that totally dovetailed with the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, totally adjustment mean the heart of Guru Pad Padma. If the heart of disciple is just equal to the heart of Guru Pad Padma Sadguru, then it is called totally adjusted. But Narottama Thakur speaking in Kirtan, Guru Mukho Padma Bakcho Hidayate Koriya Vaikyo Arna Koriya Mane Asha. This is called total adjustment. We are not totally adjusted with Rupanuga Guru Bharga, our Guru Bharga, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That's why we cannot get the result of our bhajan. We cannot do seva. The only reason for why when we are not getting actual power, the only reason is that we are totally deviated from the lotus feet of Prabhupada. And we are... The other day I was discussing how much, how far I am deviated from the lotus feet of Prabhupada. I am calculating under the guidance of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. So actually, point is that if I am deviated from the lotus feet of Prabhupada, then Gauriya Bhajan is not at all possible. Gauriya Bhajan not at all possible. In the name of Hari Bhajan, Hari Gatha, so many garbage going on. Countless questions coming to me. What to do, what not to do, Maharaj? I have already taken shelter of such and such, you know, Guru, this, that. We are less interested to criticize anybody. We have no time. But surely we are going to project actual Siddhanta. I mean, what Prabhupada wanted to speak, that always we want to project in front of you all. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that Baddha Jeev is full of anartha. Really so, we know, everybody we know. Everybody we know, we are full of anartha. And kama, krodha, lobha, moho, mado, Mascharjo, everything there. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, kama, krodha, everything, and Mascharjo, we cannot cut, it is, I can discuss this point little after. Actually, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that those kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mascharjo, everything, six kind of ripus, always acting as enemies. Prahlad Maharaj always speaking this way, different, in front of Nishingadev. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if kapotata is not there, if kapotata is not there, in that case, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, we can come out of danger. We can very easily detect Mastarjo. We cannot get any application of Mastarjo, jealousy, in Hari Bhajan. While all other fives, Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, and Mado, all Srila Narottama Thakur already have seen us. He has seen us, he has shown us the application of all those, you know. But Mastarjo is, you know, dangerous. But we can detect that Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, everything there, we can detect. But actually Kapotata is so dangerous, and Kapotata is actually a secret enemy. Kapotata, hypocrisy, Kapotata is our secret enemy. Very easily we cannot detect. You can remember the other day I was discussing that impersonalism or Mayavad can come in different, countless different form in front of us. It is quite impossible for us to detect. But pure Guru Vishnup, they can easily detect it. They can arrest. Because they have that kind of sensitivity inside their heart. That's why they can detect. Or other people, innocent people, they cannot detect. In what form can come in front of you to throw you out of Bhaktivinoda Dara, you cannot even in dream, you cannot imagine. You cannot. Very. So, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that kapatata, this hypocrisy, kapat, bab, is our secret enemy. And Raghunath Das Goswami also writing in his Manasiksha, sixth sloka, Are chetaha pradyat kapatokuti nati bhara kharo kharat mutre snatta dahasi katham atmanam opimam sada tvam gandharva giridharo pado premo bilasat sudambodho snatva samapi nituram mancha sukhayo. Are chetoho prodad kapata kutinati bharakaro. This kind of sloka. Kharad mutre snata dahasikatham atmanam upimam. This way, Raghunath Das Goswami also speaking, this kapat bhav is dangerous. If there is no quality inside the heart of one devotee, no quality there. If there is no quality inside me, still, by the causeless mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I can get everything. Only the thing, I should be very clear from heart. I mean, there should not be any kapat bhav. My heart, there should not be any duplicity. Kapat bhav should not be there. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur also compare this point and speaking that putana is the symbol of kapat bhav. So we have a putana inside our heart. We have putana inside our heart all the time, putting us in problem. Now question is that why this kind of duplicity, kapat bhav, coming inside heart? What can be the root cause? What can be the root cause of this kapat bhav? What can be the root cause of this kapat bhav? Why people going to express this kind of kapat bhav? What can be the reason? Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that this the only reason behind is that we want to get pratishtha. We want to get false pratishtha. So automatically kapatata can come. To get Pratishtha, I will have to expose myself in front of you in a very fair way. I am very so good, I have moral character, I have this much bhajan, this, that. This is the idea, you see. So, Kapat Bhav is there because we want to maintain Kapat Bhav, because we want to expose ourselves as a great devotee. Pratishtha is the only reason. And if Pratishthasa is there, 100% you cannot avoid. Automatically you can become Kapat. To collect Pratishtha, you must hide your loopholes. Suppose I have some loopholes. I have to cover up some loopholes. Otherwise, how you can respect me? This is the point. So, automatically, Kapatratha can come. So, Pratishthasa and Kapatratha, duplicity, they are bosom friends. They are staying with each other. If one is there, automatically you can detect the other. It's an automatic factor. So, Kapat Bhav is there. That's why I want to expose myself in front of you. I told you that. That impersonalism or Mayavad can come in front of us in countless different forms. Sometime with a lamination, upper lamination of very, very soft, humble character, humble mood, Trinada Visunij Bhav, external, you cannot understand. You cannot understand it, very, very impossible for you to understand. So, I am going to speak all different kind of system, I am in procedure, how to detect. Otherwise, in infinity period, if you go on doing bhajan, for infinity period, still you cannot get result. Those who are misguiding you, in the name of Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha, I like to pay dandavat unto their lotus feet, because they are indirectly Vyatirek. They are my Shiksha Guru. They are going to teach us, see our position, very painful position, situation. So you please try to check yourself by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. They are also my Shiksha Guru. And directly, indirectly, I am going to collect all Shiksha from you. Even from you also, I am going to get some lesson. This is my target. But when I am going to project all the secret Siddhanta of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, some devotee can become angry with me. But it is my duty what to do. Before my death, I will have to do this. All the time I will have to expose the absolute truth, what is the actual Siddhanta. And if you go on doing bhajan for infinity period this way, you cannot get success. You cannot come out successful. So 100%, you like or don't like, it's not a big issue. You will have to follow all this Siddhanta Vichar to protect yourself in bhajan mark. So we are habituated, I told that we are habituated to get false Pratishtha. Actual Pratishtha means Vaishnavi Pratishtha, that's not a big problem. Vaishnavi Pratishtha, tate karo nishtha, tahana kurile rovive rovra. If I am going to throw away Vaishnavi Pratishtha, and I like to go to a very solitary place and start counting Harina, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, then I can get a big punishment by Srila Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, I cannot try. That is the main problem. So, actually point is there. In the name of Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha, we are going to learn something which is not there in Bhaktivinoda Dhara. That is the main problem. That is the main problem for why we cannot get success in our bhajan. So, first of all, we must try to understand is there any duplicity inside our heart or not. If there is no duplicity, then any amount of problem is there inside our heart, any kind of weakness is there inside, that's not a big problem. Yogyota vichare kichu nahi pai tomaro koruna saro. If my Guru Maharaj is going to see analytically what kind of quality is there inside me, then surely I am not going to get diksha from Guru Pad Padma because I have no quality. But that doesn't mean I can misuse that, you know, misuse his, you know, kripa. He is going to show me causeless mercy. That doesn't mean I can take advantage of this, you know, causeless mercy, undue advantage. There is great offensive, Mayavadi. Then I am Madhava, Mayavadi. Prabhupada, in his Patravali letter, writing, day by day, Prabhupada writing in his Patravali, that day by day, those Mayavadis, they are going to come in Vaishnava society to take Diksha, Harinam, Sannyas, even Acharya Sip. Prabhupada speaking in one or two words, I am going to explain it. Prabhupada speaking, gradually, day by day, all Mayavadis, they are coming in the form of Vaishnava base to join Gauri Vaishnava society. That is the main problem. But we are so full, we cannot detect what is Mayavad, what is impersonalism, how we can do this big problem, we cannot. So for infinity period, if we go on doing bhajan with kapat bhav inside our heart and mascharya, then never we can do hari bhajan properly. That is the main. As I was speaking that day, that sometime some Mayavadi in the form of Vaishnava base, and actually Prabhupada repeatedly told us that so long as Mayavad vichar is there in our society, in the world, so long as Mayavad vichar is prevailing, so long as Mayavad vichar is prevailing in our society or in the whole world, then there cannot be any proper solution of Shuddha Bhakti. There cannot be any solution of Shuddha Bhakti. Srila Prabhupada told that by the mercy of Sarup Gosai, by the mercy of Sarup Gosai, who is the topmost authority of Gauriya Sampradaya. Prabhupada speaking, By the mercy of Sarup Gosai, we will have to throw away those Mayavadis from our Namhatta. We will have to throw away, detect one by one, arrest like detective department. Some devotee yesterday wanted to speak that, Maharaj, you are from detective department of spiritual line. I said, no. Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by their mercy, I like to speak something. I know nothing. Actually, one by one, we will have to detect those Mayavadis. And if you say, Maharaj, then how I can run my mart? Then you can go on running your mart as you like, you can do. But if you want to give full protection to the Siddhantavanian society, how to protect our whole Saraswat Goswami society? How to? That is the main issue. At present, there is no shortage of money, no shortage of nothing. Only one thing, that how to give full protection to our Siddhantavani and Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj, Saraswat Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj. This is a very typical question in front of us. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, day by day, the Mayavadis, they are coming in different form to join this Vaishnava society to make problem. So under the guidance of Sarup Gosai, we will have to arrest them and throw out of mat, out of our society. If you want to make compromise with them, then surely you cannot protect your society, I mean mat. in true sense. You can show there is bhandara, there is everything, externally everything going on, but spiritual improvement, as shown by Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that you cannot get. That is the main problem. So, actually, under the guidance of Sarup Gosai, we will have to detect those Mayavadis one by one. We can throw them out of our society. Otherwise, Namhatta, one or two days after actually disappearance day of Bhaktivinoda Thakur coming, who identify himself as the sweeper of Namhatta, and the Namhatta is the main wing of Vishnu Vaishnava Rasa Vaitra. If you want to bring some garbage here, you are going to make dirty, then there is no solution what to do. I like to show you that Sarup Gosai, even Sarup Gosai was merciful on Choto Haridas. I like to show you this point from Chaitanya Charitamrita. If you go to Chaitanya Charitamrita under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, you can find that even Sarup Gosai is so tough, so cutter, but still Sarup Gosai took the trouble to request Mahaprabhu for Choto Haridas, small Haridas. Choto Haridas somehow have done some mistake, but Mahaprabhu not going to excuse him. I was speaking so many things in favor of Brahmacharya Sannyas. I was speaking so heavily those who are maintaining Brahmacharya Sannyasis. That doesn't mean I am going to support this, that Joshi's Sangha is good. I don't think that way. Don't think that way. Maharaj speaking so heavily against Brahmacharya Sannyasi, that means Maharaj going to give some favor to those Matajis. Not that. Actually, those Matajis, they will have to also avoid Yoshit Sangha. Yoshit doesn't mean Kamini Yoshit, Kanchan Yoshit, Patishtha Yoshit. It is only you can get this kind of guidance in Gauriya Math, nowhere else. In the whole universe, nowhere you can get this kind of Siddhanta. Prabhupada speaking, those Matajis, if they are going to think about some young man to destroy his sannyas, brato, brahmacharya, this is usually happening so. Thousands of kids, countless. Those Matajis, they are coming very soft heart, showing externally soft heart, coming with very, their approach is very soft approach. Then, I have seen countless cases. They are like leopardo. Leopardo, you know? Leopardo? Very sick lady coming and catch, you know, going to bite the neck of one brahmacharya and sannyasi and gone. Countless such cases. I cannot count. This is actual bhajan at present. How we can expect power to come in your life? How we can expect to power her? How we can expect that the power to come in our life, how we can expect. Whereas I am not going to follow any rules and regulation, no achara, nothing. How? Automatically I can get power. Simply because I have taken diksha from Srila Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami, I can get power. So easy. Then why Ramchandra Puri not getting Ramchandra Puri not getting power from Ishwar Puripad? Why Ishwar Puripad getting power? So we'll have to calculate. Not that all, you know, disciples of Gurudev, not that all disciples of Gurudev getting same power. Not that all disciples of Gurudev, they are actually initiated. So you are putting question in front of me, Maharaj, what to do? Somehow I was initiated by the such and such, you know. And you are hearing Harikatha for a long time. Gauriya Siddhanta. So you simply, you will have to understand this point, that Diksha means Dibbo Gyan. If somebody is going to initiate you, some ABC, unnecessarily, you are also in the trap. you have to throw this kind of diksha. This kind of diksha is useless, no meaning at all. Without any hesitation, as per the Siddhanta Prabhupada, this kind of, because if you are going to leave Sadguru, Sadhu Vaishnava, then it is aparad. Guru tag is aparad. Otherwise, it is not aparad. So, what I wanted to speak first, then I can explain it later. So, those, you know, Prabhupada speaking, actually, Sarup Gosai is going to make one request for Chhoto Haridas. The Chhoto Haridas has done some mistake, but Mahaprabhu not at all ready to excuse him at all. Not at all. But that Sarup Gosai is not at all going to allow that Prakito Kavi, material poet, he is Mayavadi, impersonalist. Sarup Gosai was so fired up, speaking so heavily, that he was just afraid. Sarup Gosai was so angry, so fired up, that Sarup Gosai never wanted to allow that Prakita Kavi, material Kavi, who is inside heart impersonalist, Sarup Gosai never allow him to come in front of Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu also, while in South trip, when Mahaprabhu going in South India trip to deliver them, that's why you can remember, I like to give you a reminder, that Mahaprabhu speaking, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava, Rakshamam, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava, Pahimam. Why Mahaprabhu speaking this way? Mahaprabhu always chanting Harina. But that time when Mahaprabhu going, why? You don't know the reason. Because South India is full of Mayavad, who's full of Mayavad, impersonalists, they are full. And they don't understand bhakti, what is actual way. Actual bhakti, they don't understand. That's why Mahaprabhu is going to teach us that if you are going, always you will have to remember that you should not do any asasanga. I always think, Maharaj, I am very clever. I am always avoiding asasanga. No! You are not clever. You are foolish number one. You think you are clever. Everything, everybody going to think that I am very intelligent. Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, yes, they are all intelligent. They are all intelligent. Everybody think I am very intelligent. Really, you are intelligent. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they are intelligent according to their own estimation. They are intelligent, really, according to their own estimation, but not according to the estimation of Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, according to the estimation of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You are not intelligent. What do you mean by asasanga? Just now, I was 10 minutes before, I was discussing that if those who are Matajis, they think that only those who are brahmachari sannyasis, they are going to do jasis sangha. No, you are also going to do jasis sangha. Prabhupada speaking, if some mataji is going to feel some attraction for somebody, it is also jasis sangha. Jasit, this word means a mood of enjoyment, can come in the form of woman or man, or in the form of money, liquid money, or gold, ornament, pratishtha, or countless different forms. Countless different forms. What Prabhupada want to speak, that you see, Sarup Gosai is so tough, Sarup Gosai is so strict, but still Sarup Gosai going to make some request for Chhoto Haridas in front of Prabhu. Prabhu, what mistake? What mistake done by Chhoto Haridas, small Haridas? Please, can you excuse him? Mahaprabhu was so strict, so strict. Again, further, if you are going to request me, you cannot get me here in Nilachal Dham. I can go away. No, 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 no. We are not going to request you anymore. Please stay with us. Prabhupada speaking that all each and every action of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is one kind of big lesson for us. How you can understand? You can understand under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. You cannot understand. All the time, in each and every fraction of second, what Mahaprabhu is doing, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is doing, what Prabhupada is doing, all is a great lesson, big lesson for us. We are so foolish, we are still staying in front of Guru Vaishnava, we are approaching pure Guru Vaishnava, but you cannot understand their mood. We cannot understand their mood. We can find some fault with them. That is our target, because we are impersonalists. Those who are going to find some faults with pure Guru Vaishnava, 100% they are Mayavadi. Those who are going to say that we will have to edit whole writings of harmonist, 100% they are Mayavadi. 100% they are Mayavadi, otherwise they cannot speak that way. When our Ishwar Puripad requesting Nimai Gauranga Mahaprabhu in previous home, that time, Ishwar Puripad going to request Mahaprabhu, you please check up this book. I have written one book on Krishna Leela, Krishna Leela Amrita. Could you please check up this book, is there is any mistake or not? Mahaprabhu speaking, any pure devotee is writing anything, there cannot be any mistake. So I cannot edit your book. Impossible. Mahaprabhu speaking, try to arrest those Mayavadis. Maybe they are educated, they are big, big, honorable person. Try to arrest them and throw them out of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasama. Throw them out. Otherwise, infinity pure, if you go on doing bhajan, contamination you cannot avoid. To save yourself from corona, you are using sterilizer, you are using protecting your nose, eyes, everything, but you are not, you are so foolish, you are not going to protect your heart from Mayavad contamination, which is more dangerous than that corona. Hare, corona can kill you. But you see, big punishment for us. So, how different way Mayavad approaching us, we must understand it first. So, you see, Swarup Gosai even can make a request for Chhoto Haridas. But still, Swarup Gosai cannot approach, cannot allow Prakita Kavi, material Kavi, who is inside heart impersonalist. Swarup Gosai cannot allow him to go in front of Prabhu, in front of Prabhu. Those who are Mayavadi impersonalists, how countless different form. I can show how different way you can be in problem. So if somebody going to speak that we will have to edit harmonist, if somebody going to translate Patramita, Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, this and that, they are going to change the theme. They are going to change the theme to take some material advantage in future, near future. Like, you know, Lochandas Thakur writing so nicely, but Prabhupada speaking, there was a big group, those who wanted to put some unusual word in Kirtan of Lochandas Thakur. They wanted to contaminate. Even I can show, if you can bring old Bhagavatam, maybe 70 years, 80 years back, or 100 years back, when first printing, I can show that time, the, after that, some Pandit with a plan to take advantage in near future. They wanted to change the writings of Vyasadeva, and they wanted to introduce something new. Follow what I say. Even in Ramayana. In Ramayana, you know, one Ramayana was compiled by one king. He gave responsibility to one Kavi. Eh? Kirtivas Ojha. I speak openly because I don't fear. By the order of that Shakta, he was the king was Shakta. By the order of Shakta king, king was Shakta, not Vaishnava. He was bound to change some point there. And everybody, all idiot, going to read it and they're going to die. So how we can protect them? There it is written that Ramchandra going to make bridge, Shetu Bandha, in South India, at the shore of sea, Dakshin, extreme south of India. And there, Ramchandra going to worship Durga. And going to worship Durga, and going to offer 108 lotus flower. Every time one lotus flower shorting by the magic spell of Devi, and Ramchandra going to cut his own eyes and offer unto the lotus feet of Devi. How it looks? How it looks? You follow what I mean to say? All Mayavadi. Idiot number one. In Vrindavan, so nice Harikatha, everybody dancing. After that, when Harikatha is finished, that big acharya of some so-called sampradaya going to offer the result of Harikatha unto the lotus feet of Katayani Devi. Now you see, simple Siddhanta, they don't know that Harikatha is just equal to Hari. If one pure devotee is speaking Harikatha, if some platform speaker speaking Harikatha, and that is different. But when pure Guru Vaishnava speaking, Harikatha is just equal to Hari. Madhbhaktra yatra gayanti tatva tishtami Narada. O Narad, when my pure devotee is singing the glories, my glory, then be sure I am present there, always present there. So, after Harikatha is over, going to give the result of Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha, unto the lotus feet of Katayani Devi. I mean, you are going to offer Krishna as Pushpanjali unto the lotus feet of Katayani Devi. The Katayani Devi become very happy with you. Katayani ke cut your throat. Cut your throat means can never give you bhakti. But they are getting honor, position everywhere. That doesn't mean that we will have to follow that procedure. They are going to jump into the fire of Maya Devi. That doesn't mean I will have to also follow. That doesn't mean I will have to follow that. What Prabhupada told, how far, how much I am deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada, that exact, you know, final balance should be represented in front of devotees, pure devotees, so that they can help me if I have no duplicity inside my heart. So if somebody going to translate the writings of Guru Bhargava or editing, he can never change any punctuation, nothing. If you're going to speak, that says there is some mistake, the English is, are you old English? Old English, what do you mean by old English? Try to get the theme there, foolish. Many times Prabhupada told, you cannot expect a nice piece of lecture from me. I also speak this way. You cannot expect a nice piece of lecture from me because I am not a university lecturer. You cannot expect nice language from me because I am not a linguist. What you can expect from me? Sasmin bhavanch kesave. The direct feeling the direct feeling that I have received from my Guru Padma, that I can share with you. That I can share with you. Language is not such a big factor, though language is good. I cannot change the language of Prabhupada for infinity period, I can get punishment. For this, you know, those who are going to change the word of Prabhupada, you know, they want to change the theme of, you know, writing of Srila Prabhupada, they can get heavy infinity period. They cannot get bhakti. They can go down and down and down. I can discuss tomorrow. Kriya sakta nadhik vikata sabdasa dhikcha jamin. I can discuss this point. First point is that Mayavad can come in countless different form in front of me. Sarup Gosai rather can give some facility to Choto Haridas, small Haridas. Still Sarup Gosai cannot allow that impersonalist to approach, because Prabhupada speaking, so long as Mayavad Vichar is there, prevailing in this society, then we cannot establish pure devotion. Countless devotees, they are going to follow them. How I can protect them? How I can protect them? There is actually one big market by Mayadevi. There is a big market by Mayadevi. Different kind of, you know, shops are there. Mayavadi, they are opening also nice shop to deliver nice, sweet, you know, philosophy. Mayavadi. And those who are XY mission, Karmi, Jnani, all they have and their respective exhibition. They are going to open in front of you. And how I can protect you? Because you are enjoying liberty. You are not under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. Prabhupada speaking, for infinity period, we cannot go out of this Mayavad Vichar. To protect yourself, the only way open, Prabhupada speaking, only and only you will have to follow a pure Guru Vaishnava. Only and only you will have to follow a pure Guru Vaishnava to protect yourself from Mayavad. Impersonalist or Kormi, Jnani. So, the only way. Then you can develop that kind of sensitivity gradually by Guru Vaishnava Seva. Then you can understand very easily. So impersonalists can come. So those who are going to change the writing of Prabhupada, they are very, you know, puffed up, they are speaking that English is old English, we'll have to change. They are all, you know, Mayavadi. They are not Vaishnava. Changing the, you know, original writing of Prabhupada. But because in near future they can get, I already told. So many things, garbage. It is pre-planned. And just 20 years back, 25 years back, there was a big fighting. About two sloka from Padma Purana. Mayavad asa sastram, this sloka. In Kali Kal, in Kali Yuga, there are four sampradaya you can get. And those who are going to follow this, you know, this pure sampradaya perfectly, they can get power, or other people, they are not going to. They are not going to get in. They should have one original link from original sampradaya, original place. Otherwise, you cannot expect. So, Mahaprabhu speaking, I cannot edit your book. It's not possible. Writings of pure devotees are always okay. Because we'll have to take the theme always. Mahaprabhu speaking. This way we find that If I going to change the writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, this great offense for me. I will be heavily punished in near future. So, sometime some bonded soul, they are requesting me, Maharaj, that Acharya requesting me to write one article in their magazine. I say, what do you think? So, I should write or should not write? I say, you are foolish number one. Why, Maharaj? They want to put you into inside trap. Inside trap, they like to put, like in Sabha. They are so clever. They know how to put you inside cage, inside trap. Inside Sabha, they can request, Prabhu, you can also speak some Harikatha in front of public. Hari, foolish number one. Whereas you don't know how to speak, what is Siddhanta, nothing, he requests simply to give you false Patishtha. Because they are very clever, they know if I am going to give this Patishtha, surely he can come in front of me and I can use him, his energy, for my personal Patishtha, not for Prabhupada. Then they are not at all going to use your energy and money. I am sitting in Vyasasan, I can touch the lotus feet of Nishingadev and say, they are not going to utilize your energy and money, everything, for the preaching of Gaurvani. They are going to use it for their personal purpose. If they are going to give you this kind of facility, Prabhu, you can speak some Harikatha. Then automatically you can say, oh, so soft, so gentle. I already did with a lamination of, with a very, you know, nice lamination of gentle behavior, softness, Trinadapi. It's not actually Trinadapi. They can put you into trap, then they can make you their own servant. Whole life you will have to do it. They are requesting you to write one article in their magazine. Eh? Whereas is they already know, he is knowing that what you can write. You have no Siddhanta, can nothing, no nothing. Whereas countless Siddhanta Vichar, countless writings of, that is their, you know, that is their trick. Countless writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Kesab Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Goswami Maharaj waiting for us. Even cannot get the scope to catch our attention. We are so clever, we like to sell the library to somebody, so that old library if sold, then old document cannot come. So they cannot find any documents. Follow. If they can find, then they can arrest me, Maharaj, you are saying. So in newly published, new edition of Padma Puran, you cannot find this sloka. Kalo Uchattara Sampradaya, four Sampradayas are there. They cannot find this sloka. They already omit. They put purpose with a great, you know, they are very clever. They cannot allow you to read this sloka. Sometimes this is a planning, pre-plan. They like to change the sloka and put something new. It's contamination they are doing. You cannot understand. Follow. This way, they are contaminated. Now my question is there, whereas countless writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, countless writings of Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda are waiting for us. Whereas he is going to make you recover. You are foolish number one, idiot number one. You also think, oh Maharaj, so nice, so soft, he is going to... Foolish number one. You cannot understand. They like to put you into trap, inside trap, give you false honor, this, that. They cannot allow a pure devotee to speak. They cannot allow pure devotee to speak. They always like to avoid them because... If they can't come in, if they are coming in front of pure devotees, then they come very, they are very afraid. They fear to come in front, because no, if they are coming in front of pure devotee, speak something, then that pure devotee can arrest him. That is Mayavadi. You speak one or two words, they can arrest. You are Mayavadi. You are speaking this way. You are Mayavadi. In the form of Acharya, in the form of, you know. This way, you should accept Vaishnavi Pratishtha. You should accept Vaishnavi Pratishtha, not all Pratishtha, any kind of Pratishtha coming to you, you cannot accept. You should accept Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Vaishnavi Pratishtha, what do you mean by Vaishnavi Pratishtha? Prabhupada speaking, Vaishnavi Pratishtha, Tatekara Nishtha, Tahana Kurile Ravyo. Vaishnavi Pratishtha mean any kind of Pratishtha coming to you when you are in the line of Sadguru Vaishnav, when you are in the line of Bhaktivinoda Dara, any kind of Pratishtha, already you are in the line of Bhaktivinoda Dara, any kind of Pratishtha coming in your life, not going to contaminate your heart. That is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Any amount of garland, any amount of pranami, anabhati, you can try. You cannot change the heart of pure Guru Vaishnava. They are not going to accept it. So any pratishtha coming to you, Vaishnava pratishtha, you will have to pass on this pratishtha to your Guru Varga. That is called Vaishnava pratishtha. That is why you can remember long ago, I was discussing about Ekayan Pradhati, the one-way procedure. Ekayan Pradhati. Ekayan Pradhati mean separately you cannot try to get Pratishtha this, that. If you are already in the lotus feet of Guru Pad, Padma, Sadguru and Vaishnava, any kind of Pratishtha coming to you, that you can accept. That is called Ekayan Pradhati. This is called Ekayan Pantha. One-pointed devotion. With this procedure, you'll have to show devotion and any kind of an honor, any kind of things coming in your life, you are going to offer those things unto a lotus feet of your Guru Varga, not going to contaminate your heart. When you are totally established in Bhaktivinoda Dara, then your Pratishtha is Vaishnavi Pratishtha, otherwise it is not Vaishnavi Pratishtha, it can throw you away from bhajan. So be careful about this. So all in different forms, this Mayavad Vichar can come in your life. So Mayavad Vichar can come in your life in different form. Actually, how far, how much I am deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada to detect it, you'll have to understand this point. That Prabhupada speaking this, but I am going to accept different kind of false pratishtha, because without pratishtha I cannot do any seva. Without pratishtha I cannot externally I am going to open an exhibition of Trinadapi. Be careful. Externally, I am going to open an exhibition of Trinadapi. Oh, I am so Adam, so fallen soul, I have nothing. In this Sava, I am sitting here to hear something from you all, not to speak something. All idiot people, they can think that he is very humble. All foolish people, they can immediately understand he is very humble, Maharaj, so humble. But if there is any pure devotee, he can arrest him. He is Mayavadi. Because his external exposure of his weakness is also with a plan to get some pratishtha. If I am going to speak that I am Adam, I am Patita, I have nothing, that means you can think that he is very humbler than the blade of grass, Trinadapi. Then you can get more and more pratishtha to him. That is one kind of stool and urine. Yogananda Das Goswami speaking stool and urine. And Prabhupada also speaking. The stool and urine is material pratishtha as stool and urine. All can come. And this is the procedure through which those Mayavadis, those impersonalists, they are very demon. Externally, they are very, they can show open an exhibition of humbleness. Inside, they are like leopardo. Very, very sharp. They like to kill you. They like to finish you. They like to finish your spiritual career, but they don't know. Those who are established unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma Prabhupada, how we can finish them? How we can kill them? So many, people wanted to kill Prabhupada, finish Prabhupada in Puri, in Mayapur, simply because Prabhupada wanted to project about absolute truth. Prabhupada wanted to speak about that absolute truth. That is his fault. Why Guru Vaishnava not going to cheat me with false philosophy? I am so foolish. Why Guru Vaishnava not going to cheat me by false philosophy? Why not? They are not going to cheat me? If they are cheating me, then they are very nice Vaishnava. He is speaking all about the absolute. No, he is no Vaishnavata, no humble attitude, nothing. Follow. You are going to get this kind of, you expect this kind of behavior? If Guru Vaishnava going to give me some false pratishtha, if Guru Vaishnava not going to stop me from doing wrong activities, apasiddhanta, all wrong activities, if Guru Vaishnava going to arrest your personal, desire to fulfill your personal, you are trying, Guru Vaishnava going to arrest you, in that case you say, we cannot stay with them because they are not at all Vaishnava. They cannot adjust with us. Why? They want to arrest me. I am going opposite way, wrong. If they are not going to give approval for my false pratishtha, if they are going to arrest me from fall down, not giving me indulgence for my wrong activities, if they are going to stop my enjoying mood, I have some enjoying mood inside, then we can say we should leave that Guru Vaishnava. They have no Vaishnavata. Then they have no adjustment power because we should throw them out. When Prabhupada is speaking that we are going to live only for a few days, so under the guidance of Asraya Vigraha, we must stay with full adjustment. We can stay and go on doing seva of that Vishaya Vigraha under the guidance of Asraya Vigraha. Prabhupada speaking. But what I am speaking? My vichar is, what kind of vichar? My vichar is that to reconcile. Oh, adjustment mean chit jaro samannoy. Chit, transcendental and matter. Jaro, and adjustment. Matter, chit, mean transcendental, chit and jaro can never be adjusted. Chit and jara, matter and antimatter, transcendental things, can never be adjusted. So I am so foolish. I am speaking, Maharaj, to run a ma, to run a spiritual society, we must do adjustment, but Prabhupada not speaking this way. I am totally deviated from the track of Prabhupada. I am deviated so far, so much, that I don't understand the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. Prabhupada never speak that way. When I am going to discuss about big, big things, whereas I have no saranagati, I cannot prove that I have saranagati. When simple saranagati is not there, I want to learn Rupanuga, but I like to start Rupanuga bhajan. How is that possible? I don't know. Whereas simple saranagati is not there, basic thing is not there, not even kindergarten study, infant in kindergarten study is not there. But how I can learn Rupanuga bhajan? So how much I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada you can discover if you are not foolish. Whereas I can show you in Patravali, in later Prabhupada's writing, always we will have to discuss about the rasa expressed by devotees. Bhakta rasa. They are Korun ras, they are sometimes, they are different kind of rasas, devotees. Different devotees, they will have to discuss their topics to understand their rasa bodh, their sensitivity of rasa. We'll have to discuss all about them. Prabhupada speaking in his letter. All the time you will have to discuss about transcendental rasa of those devotees. You know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, how doing exclusive bhajan, this, that. Not Ashray Vigraha. Ashray Vigraha means or Guru Vaishnava. Abhishay Vigraha Krishna. So I like to throw Ashray Vigraha, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, as per parampara, what kind of teachings and lesson I am getting, I like to throw everything, I like to make a new rules and regulation. So how far, how much I am deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada, I will have to discover. You will have to discover, no? How far, how much, whereas Prabhupada speaking this, you are doing this. Prabhupada speaking this, you are doing this. So long as Mayavad, you know, impersonalist, they are going to stay, going to make different kind of plan in front of you, be sure we cannot do pure devotion is at present rare. Pure devotion is almost rare, impossible. If we going to get satisfaction, Maharaj, at least I am doing Harinam, getting up early. You think any of your action is bhakti? You think so? You get up early in the morning, 4 o'clock, what it concern to Krishna? What it concern to Krishna? You are getting up early in the morning to get your facility, your body, mind, to start, do bhajan. You are going to read so many stotra. So what it concern to Krishna? You are going to protect your body through Nishinga Kavaj, Nishinga Archan. You are doing? You are going to drink milk. What it concern to Krishna? You are going to take bath 3-4 times. What it concern to Krishna? What kind of facility Krishna can get? What do you mean by bhakti? I am staying in Dham, Maharaj, at least. You are staying in Dham? Guru Padmanabha used to stay. That in writing also Guru Maharaj writing, that they can think we are in mud. Guru Padmanabha speaking, they think we are in mud, but actually they are in Komat. Komat, you know, where you are passing stool. Guru Padmanabha, they are not staying in mud. Mud and Komat. They are staying in Komat. Insects of the stool, always busy to do business in Dham. Just this way. We want to arrange one place where Harikatha, neutral Harikatha can be done, but so countless problem coming. I say it is a blessing of Krishna. They like to make business. Okay. I can sit under the banyan tree and speak Harikatha. So what it concern to me? There is noise, this much problem. Or in Goshala. This way I can speak. So I don't need anything. There's big problem. They like to make business. They like to make business. They are staying in Dham to make business. They have taken sannyas to do business. They are acharya to do business. So why not you go openly and do business? Contamination everywhere. How you can protect yourself? Countless problems coming. So how to protect? I am reciting stotra. What is concerned to? I am reciting stotra for the satisfaction of Krishna or for myself. I am reciting Nishinga Kavach to protect my body. This is my bhakti. The Yashodama can early in the morning can get up and can start reading stotra. Jasonama from a morning time going to serve Krishna. We have no serving mood. That is the main problem. We have no serving mood. All the what is your success, you know. All the 24 hours you can, if you can engage yourself in seva, that is your bhajan siddhi. That is your bhajan siddhi. If you know the tactics, how to engage yourself in bhajan seva all the time, that is called tactics. If you can understand this point, how to satisfy Krishna, Guru, Gauranga, that is called actual bhajan. Your 25,000 harinam, 50,000 harinam, cannot satisfy Krishna. The moment you can satisfy your saranagati unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, if you can sell your head, I promise you, if you can sell your head unto the lotus feet of a pure Guru Vaishnava, the day, not day, the moment, you can get result, you can feel some power. Some devotees from Vrindavan speaking, Maharaj, when I heard from your Harikatha that 4 lakhs harinam, 1 lakh harinam, you can do within 4 hours. I was thinking it is one gossip. How Maharaj speaking this? But now, by your mercy, I am getting power just like within 4 hours. I am doing more and more harinam. Because he is doing some seva, actual seva. Not to get name and fame. Very secret seva, Bani Seva is doing. That's why they are getting power. And if this kind of power you like to misuse, then you can get penalty for that. So this way actually, all the time we must understand that pure devotional activities, one point of devotion is not a matter of joke. Countless philosophies are there. In market, different kind of things are available. I cannot stop you from going there. You can go to see, to buy. How I can protect you? The day you are going to cut all your anavilas, any kind of self-interest, just the day you can discover that any kind of self-interest is just Maharaj, vanish from my heart. The day you can discover any desire of pure Guru Vaishnava, any desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, any desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, it should be your desire. If you can harmonize all your heart with pure Guru Vaishnava, then you can get result. If there is disparity, then how you can get result? Power cannot come. So you see, it is the plan, it is the you know, wicked when a plan of Mayavadis to approach you very sweet way all the time. They are making a nice plan. And they can change the writing of authentic writer like Krishna, they can try. Vyasadeva Goswami Bhagavatam, some changes somebody can make. Somebody can make the writings of Lochandas Thakur. This way they like to change. Like they are changing the more, changing the theme of Prabhupada, they are translating. You need not translate. You need not say, you go to hell. You need not translate. You think you are very big man, you have billions of dollars, you think you are very big man. When you are going to leave your body, where you can get? Where you can go? Where you can stay, where you can keep your money power when you are going to die? You can keep all your money power, all everything can be go to hell. So this way, Mayavadi always going to put us in trouble all the time. All the time, Mayavad going to put us in trouble. So Kapatya and Anugatya is just two opposite poles. Kapatya, I mean hypocrisy, duplicity, and Anugatya. duplicity and anugatha, submission, totally separate, opposite pole. How we can expect? How we can expect that how we can expect that we can come out successful? Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in his article if duplicity is there, surely he is going to take the help of lie. And I told you, in the name of Harikatha, Harivajan, nice philosophy, they are going to speak half truth. Half truth is more dangerous than full truth. Full lie. Dangerous. So if duplicity is there, then we cannot expect anugatha. So then Bhaktivinoda Thakur can throw us by boon. Bhaktivinoda Thakur can throw us as garbage from the area of Namhatta. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, satsanga, what do you mean by satsanga? What do you mean by satsanga? Satsanga means who is not going to stop you doing all rubbish. It's very soft, that's why you think satsanga. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that satsanga means who is niskapat, who is fair and above board. Jagadananda Pandit writing, sarol haile gorar shikha bujiya loibe, in Bengali. Sarol haile. If there is no duplicity inside your heart, then by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, easily you can understand all the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sarol haile gorar shikha bujiya loibe. Sarol haile, if your heart is very plain heart, very clean, antare bahire shama vyavahar amani manodo hobo, amani mean, you are not going to take any pratishtha, you are less interested. Then you are saral. Then you are saral. Then you can get kipa. So antare bahire shama vyavahar mean, what is there inside your heart? That you are speaking. Not that in heart something, you are speaking something else. That is not Siddhanta. So sarol means niskapat satsanga. If you are going to get the association of a sadhu who is without any duplicity, speaking what is speaking and what is, you know, what is inside heart and speaking same thing. That's when Bhaktivinoda Thakur is doing sarol and niskapat. Sarol and niskapat. With no duplicity and very plain-hearted. Plain-hearted means not going to reserve any pratishtha for himself. Saral means not, saral means straight. There is no bent. What do you mean? Saral means there is no desire inside heart to reserve something for himself. That is called saralata. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, satsanga means who is saral, without any desire to get any pratishtha, and at the same time with niskapat, no duplicity inside heart. Jesham saisha bhagavan dayed ananta sarvatmana asrita padam yadi nirvalikam te dustaram mati taranti cha devamayam na mamahumiti dhi sa sigala bhakshe. So what is written in Bhagavatam? What is written? That the Anantadev, Jesham Saesha Bhagavan Dayaed Ananta. Anantadev means Akar Guru Tattva. I mean Gurudev. Gurudev, Anantadev, Ballaji Maharaj, Jesham sa esha bhagavan dayayed ananta sarvatmana asrita padam yadi nirvalikam. I am going to get full kripa of Nityananda, Guru Tattva, Akar Guru Tattva, all Guru Varga, who is not going to show duplicity. Jesham sa esha bhagavan dayayed ananta sarvatmana asrita padam. From bottom of heart, from the core of heart, you are totally inclined unto lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Totally, you are not going to reserve anything, any pratishtha, nothing for you. Then automatically you can get pratishtha. When you are less interested to get pratishtha, then automatically the whole world is going to get pratishtha because you are less interested. Like Madhavendra Puripa. Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava always wanted to, always want to project this all secret things in front of us. We want to increase the member of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. All Guru Vargagan, then the condition of these, you know, very poor condition. We want to increase the number of members of Vishwa Vaishnava so that you can take up this job of cleaning the whole world. It's impossible almost. So, Jesham says, Bhagavan Daya, Edo Ananta Sarvatma Asidabhadam, from bottom of core, from the core of heart, you are going to show inclination. Then no problem. Jodi Nirvalikam, Nirvalikam Niskapat. So already I say, Saralata, straightness, you know, a simplicity, I mean straightness of heart, no duplicity there. Then automatically you can get keeper of Anantadeva. Jesham says, Bhagavan da ed Ananta Sarvatmana Asitabadam Sarvatmana Asitabadam Jodi Nirvalikam. Only and only they can cross over this material ocean. Only and only they can cross over this painful, fearful material ocean. Sarvatmana Asitabadam Nirvalikam. Te te janaha te dustaram otitarantica deva maya. Deva maya, even after taking sannyasi, you are going to expect some Mataji can message your leg, can give some seva to you, you want to prove that you are mayavadi. Mayavadi. Mahaprabhu cannot kick you. Mayadevi can kick you. If I am going to get a kick from Mahaprabhu is good, but Mayadevi can kick me. So I am expecting seva. I am expecting seva from you all. This is called Mayavad Vichar. When in toto, everything I am going to offer unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, in the account of Guru Vaishnava, then it's good. To cross over this material ocean, not a matter of joke. You can take sannyas base, you can take brahmachari base, or even you can in go home, and you can follow Brahmacharya Jabhata and whatever you like you can do. But what result? What result? Always and every time you will have to think that how I can satisfy Supreme Lord. The procedure. To cross over this material ocean, not a matter of not a matter of joke. Te dustaram otitaram chuta deva deva mayam. Deva mayam ane? Deva mayam ane? Dangerous, deva mayam. Deva mayam can come in different form in front of you, deva mayam. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhava, Uddhava. Maya can come in different form in front of you, in different countless form can come to you. In Bhagavatam, Krishna speaking to Uddhava, Drishta Sriyam Deva Mayam Tad Bhavai Rajitendriya Pralobhitaha Patatyandhe Tamasi Aganu Patangabat. Drishta Sriyam Yashit Kamini Yashit Kanchan Yadis Patisha Yadis is so lucrative that you cannot avoid the attraction of those things. That means you cannot do bhajan. Say, hey, Krishna speaking to the Drishta Sriyam Deva Mayam. It is Deva Maya. Guru Padma used to speak and laughing. Guru Padma used to speak. That Baba, they are speaking with all Matajis openly. You know, they don't know if they are going to make some plan to break your, you know, resolution. Brata, bow, they can break very easily. Mayadevi can provide a big kick inside my, on my heart, chest, and break all brata. So, so powerful. So, drishta sriyam, drishtva sriyam devamayam, tad bhavair ajitendriyaha. Even Shankar Bhagavan, in Shankar Bhagavan wanted to see the leela of Mahini, Mahini. Krishna speaking, what use actually? No, no, I like to see. Then when Mahini avatar came in front of Shankar, Shankar also Kamjayi, Mrityunjayi, Shankar. And then after that, Krishna laughing. What happens? You are Kamjayi, you are Mrityunjayi. What happens to you? Oh, my, oh, sorry, sorry, sorry. Drishtva sriyam devamayam tad bhavai rajitendriyaha. Ajitendriya, drishtva sriyam devamayam tad bhavai ajitendriya. Prolovitaha patati andhe tamasi agnu patangovat. Just like insect, they are firing, they are jumping into fire, you know. Yeah, just before Kali Puja, so many insects, coming, appear. They jump into fire. Then no, we can die, but still they are going to die. So this way actually, Prolobhita Patati Andhe, so Deva Maya, Daivi Maya can come in front of in all different forms. Krishna speaking to Uddhava, Uddhava, when somebody is going to take resolution, bow, to observe sannyas brahmacharya, different kind of Maya can come in front of them to throw them out of bhajan. If they are going to feel some attraction, that's why many times I told before, Prabhupada speaking, first of all, we must go out of any attraction and repulsion in society. In one family, only three members, one daughter, father and mother, they all staying in separate ayas land, no adjustment. Only three members. One daughter, father, mother. Father staying different way, a same flat, but different. How they can expect to do Hari Bhajan? They cannot adjust with father, mother, their, you know, children, they, how they can expect to do Hari Bhajan? Hari Bhajan is only possible for them, those who can adjust with whole universe. But that doesn't mean they can adjust with Mayavadi. Don't try to apply this medicine for me. Maharaj, you already told, you want to apply this, you know, same missile. No, try to understand this point. They can get adjustment because one pure devotee can watch that everybody doing Hari Bhajan. I cannot do Hari Bhajan properly. They are all staying in separate island. They all like to They would like to maintain their own privacy. They want to protect their own privacy. How they can expect no adjustment, no mutual cooperation, attraction and repulsion? She cannot look him, he cannot look, adjust this kind of always disparity, repulsion. So, so long as you are going to feel attraction and repulsion, you are long away from the lotus feet of Prabhupada. So, Joshit Sangha tagai, Asas Sangha tagai Vaishnava Asar. Asas Sangha tagai Vaishnava Asar. Asas Sangha means Joshit Sangha, Joshit Sanghi Sangha, and Krishna Bhaktuar. I already told in the beginning that I was not supporting those Matajis. I am not in favor of Matajis. No, I am not. I am neither. I am in favor of Matajis nor in favor of Pitajis. I am in favor of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't think that way. So always those Matajis, they must be very careful. They should protect themselves in such a way. They should behave such a way. That bonded soul, they are following Brahmacharya Vata, they cannot feel any attraction. There is also that duty. They should think that They are coming in bhajan. Nobody can come in bhajan. If somebody coming in bhajan, how I can arrange their fall down? It's not good. So, Prabhupada speaking, not that only those men going to feel attraction for women, that is on a Joshi Sangha. Also the opposite is 100% applicable in bhajan. Because we are interested about jivatma, not body. This is one kind of magic spell. According to a karma fall, you are going to get this body, you are Mataji. And next day, next birth, maybe you are Pitaji, and Pitaji, and he can become Mataji. Who can say? Brahmando Brahmito Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasad, all infinity pure, this kind of rotation going on. All the time, rotation going on. So, to protect your bhajan, you must be very careful all the time and follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada all the time. You will have to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. So, as per the advice of Rupa Goswami Pad, we must follow this. Any kind of thing which is favorable for Hari Bhajan, I can accept. What is not at all favorable for Krishna Bhajan, I can throw away. Anukulyasya sankalpa pratikulya vivarjanam. Anukulyasya sankalpa pratikulya vivarjanam. What is favorable for you, for Hari Bhajan, that you can accept. But you are going to accept what is favorable for your body and mind. So how you can avoid asatsanga? Asatsanga thage Vaishnava achar. If you want to become Vaishnava, first thing you will have to do. You will have to avoid all different countless asatsanga you will have to cut. And what is asatsanga, what is satsanga? You have to realize. Through Harikatha, you will have to realize, Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to do Haribhajan, not going to leave Asasanga, this is one kind of Prabhupada's writing is, you know, it is one kind of worm. If you are taking all different kind of nice prasadam means tasty prasadam, you see. But still you are, your body not getting nourishment, because this worm inside your belly, going to eat up those vitals of your, you know, intake. But you are taking nice milk and this, that, paramanna, all everything, nice thing, kaju, kismis, all inside your belly there is worm going to take up. Prabhupada speaking, giving this example. Until and unless you are going to avoid all asasanga with full resolution. Even my father is asasanga, I must throw him out. I cannot. Externally they can say in same room, but I cannot. So anukulyasa sankalpa pratikulya vivarjana, not a matter of joke. To understand this point, secret point. What is anukul? What is pratikul? What is just opposite of bhakti? What is just favorable for bhakti? To understand this point, it will take, you know, long time for you. Because you are not hearing Harikatha properly. You are not going to digest Harikatha. The Prabhupada speaking, satsanga means you will have to avoid asatsanga totally. Otherwise, all the vitals of your bhajan, and you know, those insects inside your belly going to eat up, and you are not going to get nourishment. So why we are not getting power in bhajan? Why different kind of problem? Try to see the whole world in relation of Supreme Lord. I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Prabhupada never used to see this is woman, this is man, this is, you know, no. Prabhupada used to see that all in relation to Krishna, everything, whole world. Any item we get in front of us, anybody, your wife, your children, all your property, everything is an item of Krishna bhajan, through which you can do exact Krishna bhajan. You should not have any enjoying mood. So, pure devotee is always thinking that anything in front of me, directly or indirectly, we are going to use for Krishna seva. Kapatata, you have no right to, you have no right to show duplicate attitude. You have no right to show duplicity. No right. Duplicity, only Krishna can show duplicity. Only Krishna can show duplicity. The only right, Krishna has only right. Only and only Krishna is the supreme enjoyer. Krishna can enjoy. I cannot express this kind of mood, enjoying mood. Krishna can keep, Krishna can reserve the right, full right of enjoyment. Full right of kapara, everything Krishna can do. But still it is good for him. There is no... And also pure Guru Vaishnava, how going to show some, you know, tactics. You can say Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is also having duplicity. No. Gaurakishore Baba very often used to say to Prabhupada, Amar Prabhu, Lokke Bhoga Diye Apni Krishna Bhajane Niyojito Thakun. My Prabhu, try to engage in Hari Bhajan. Make fool of them. Make fool of them. They are coming to disturb you. Make fool of them and try to engage you in Hari Bhajan, Hari Naam, Hari Bhajan. Only and only pure Guru Vaishnava, they can have this kind of sweet duplicity. Jejan Krishna Bhaje Sejan Hai Bada Chatur. Who is going to do exact Krishna Bhajan is very clever. How to do Krishna Bhajan, they know. How to maintain Krishna Bhajan, how to make fool of you. Because you want Pratishtha, they can give you Pratishtha and they are always engaged in Krishna Bhajan all the time. This way actually, this is one kind of very secret thing of Krishna Bhajan. When we can discuss this point, Srila Prabhupada and Radha Dasa, we can discuss all these points. So you see, Anugatha and duplicity is totally opposite poles. Not staying. So, all the time we will have to follow Sarup Gosai, and under the guidance of Sarup Gosai, we will have to detect those Mayavadis one by one, we will have to throw them out of Krishna Bhajan. In the field of, from the field of Nam Hatta, we will have to throw them away. So, how you can understand? How you can, because many such things happened in the past. In front of Prabhupada, some devotee came. But after hearing Harikatha for one or two days, and he was very annoyed, very disturbed, feeling disturbance. Hey, Prabhupada always speaking this way. It's mean only Prabhupada is sadhu and no sadhu is there. I cannot stay here. Then his friend, Paramananda Prabhu going to, please stay. Don't misunderstand Prabhupada. No, I don't like to waste my... You hear Harikatha. It is my request to you, don't go back. You hear Harikatha more 7 days, then you can gradually understand. Then by the request of friend, Paramananda Prabhu, okay, let me hear. Then after hearing for 7-10 days, he come to the conclusion, really so? Really so, this kind of Harikatha is rare Harikatha. This is actually Harikatha. We think Harikatha means enjoyment. We think Harikatha means enjoyment. We can get some enjoyment. But Harikatha means transcendental speech you can hear and you can have the scope to change your heart, clean your heart. This is called Harikatha. But you think those who are going to approach, you know, show some sweet behavior to you, this way, speaking very softly, that is Harikatha. You think so. You want to cure your disease? At the same time, you cannot rely on doctor. You want to cure your disease, Baba Rog. At the same time, you are not going to rely on the doctor. So what doctor can do? Doctor can what medicine? Doctor Guru Vaishnava going to give medicine. Medicine, with medicine you have no right to fight. Maybe it is bitter, maybe it is sweet, maybe it is sour. You have no right to fight with this medicine. Only and only without any argument, you will have to take medicine, and very shortly you can find your disease is vanished, and you can get the scope to engage yourself in Hari Bhajan all the time. That technique you will have to know. Not that you can put pressure on some Maharaj. Maharaj, you will have to give Harinam, Mala, this, that. What you can do? First of all, you will try to adjust yourself. Efficacy, you will have to learn. You come from saloon, save your, you know, head, everything, you enter into your room and touch everything. Minimum etiquette, you don't know, you don't know nothing about how to maintain purity. You have to learn what kind of purity you should maintain. You should maintain purity, internal purity and external purity, all you have to. You have to go on hearing Harikatha, then gradually you can get the power to control your sense organ. Until and unless you have the scope to get control over your mind and sense organ, how you can do Hari Bhajan? You cannot do even 25,000 Harinam. You cannot do. Because your Harinam is material. How far I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada? But I think Harinam is separate, and this is all separate. No, Prabhupada speaking, that to speak Harinam and to meet with Hari all the same. So now you can discover how far we are deviated from the track. Prabhupada always wanted to teach us that try to do seva without any expectation, with full dedication. Whereas I am not going to follow this procedure. Always I like to reserve some right, some profit for me. This is my Guru Seva. So I am not getting any power. That's why I am not going to get any power. So all the time we will have to think what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Because if this Maharaj, that Maharaj going to give advice, it is my question to you, they can take your responsibility? They can take your responsibility, then you can follow them, go and follow them. If they can take your full responsibility to deliver you from this material world, then you can go and follow them. Nobody going to take your responsibility, be careful, merciless. Nobody going to take your responsibility, only they like to take your money, position, honor, they like to snatch from you. In the name of Harikatha. One society you cannot maintain. You are going to make new temple. Stop making temple at present. Only one temple you cannot maintain. You are going to make temple. You are like Prabhupada. These are all, you know, problems. We are inviting. Day by day we are inviting problems. Yeah, day by day we are going to invite problems in our sampradaya. What it concern to me? I can get pratishtha and go away from this world and let the sampradaya die. This is our attitude. Nobody interested to take step, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking long ago. To save sampradaya, we will have to think very carefully how to save sampradaya. And Harikatha is the main thing, Harikirtan Harikatha. Prabhupada sometimes Prabhupada sometimes used to do banchana to give false pratishtha to somebody. But in the Bani Sharupa Prabhupada, there is no duplicity. Is the actually those who are pure Guru Vishnu, they always play, they are going to play that way. It is their tactics of bhajan. Always they are going to play that way. Gaur Kishore Baba, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They, foolish people, they cannot understand. They cannot understand. But in their Bani Seva, when they are going, when you are going to follow the Bani Sharup of Guru Vishnu, pure Guru Vishnu, then you can get full answer. Sometimes they can come in front of you, make some joking in front of you, but try to be very careful. When you go through their Bani Seva, then you can understand their Bani Sharup. In Bani Sharup of any Mahajan, there is no duplicity. To protect bhajan, to do maximum bhajan, you know, seva. Like I told many times, na? Prabhupada speaking, I am ready to give pratishtha to you. If ultimately it is going to give me extra facility for Hari Bhajan. If I can get the scope to serve Krishna, then I can give you pratishtha. So what is problem to me? Follow what I say. So Mahaprabhu never wanted to see the face of, you know, those who are Jasis Sangha. Mahaprabhu never wanted. Mahaprabhu wanted to set one example, milestone. Like Jagadananda Purni speaking, Jodi pranay rakhite chao gaurange shane, choto haridaser katha thake jano mone. If you like to make a nice relationship with Prabhu, loveful relation, be careful. You must remember the topics of the punishment of Choto Haridas. Choto Haridasir Kota Thaki Janamuni. So Mahaprabhu wanted to show us how to maintain their life. That doesn't mean Mahaprabhu used to hate a woman. Not that. Mahaprabhu wanted to set some example. Next day I can discuss. That Mahaprabhu speaking, that it is far better to take poison than to take Jasis Sangha. This, that is far better to take poison and die. Follow what I say. What a dangerous thing. So those pure Guru Vaishnava, they are not going to advise you to hate, you know, Matajis. They are not going to teach you that you must hate Mataji. Not that. But whatever which is feasible, you should accept. You should accept it. So when you are going to external shape and design, so long you are going to concentrate on external shape and design, you have no right to go for preaching. Because you can see nice Matajis, beautiful Matajis, handsome boy, this. So you have no right. So long as you are busy with your shape and design, you have no right to go. Brahmachari Sannyasi should be very careful from heart, not only externally you can say, see, I am so renounced. Not that. It is Mayavad. So if Suklamba Brahmachari is going to take milk, what is concerned to Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu is speaking, you are taking milk, that doesn't mean you can get me. What do you mean to say? So if you are maintaining some rules and regulation, getting up 3 o'clock, that doesn't mean you can get Krishna. All you have to make favorable. All you have to make favorable of Krishna. In favor of Krishna Vajan, you should do it. So Brahmachari Sannyasi cannot take a small baby in lap to kiss. In my mot also, I was so strict. From rooftop, I am watching one Brahmachari going to take one small baby from the lap of mother and kissing. I wanted to kick him. Everybody against me. But I told Maharaj, it is one kind of passive calm. It is one kind of passive calm. We cannot take one small baby in lap to kiss. We can bless. We can love from, you know, but we have no right. Because somehow, if we can develop, you know, that desire for Grihastha Dharma, is dangerous. It is called passive calm. It's called passive calm. Passive calm can come in different form to put me in trouble. I must love a small baby, 100%. I must love, I must bless. That doesn't mean I can break all rules and regulations and show some extraordinary. Mahaprabhu never did it. So, Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us that there should not be any enjoying mood. Mahaprabhu never wanted to speak. Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us Sri Sambhasan. Why Chota Haridas was given punishment? Sri Sambhasan. Sambhasan means, you know, talking with woman, with one enjoying mood, have some secret desire. And very, that Mahaprabhu as Paramatma inside hearts, inside heart Mahaprabhu staying. That is called Sambhasan, Sri Sambhasan. That's why Mahaprabhu was very angry. That's why Mahaprabhu speaking in Jagadananda Pandit writing, Jodi Pranay Rakhita Cha Gaurange Shane, if you want to maintain a nice sweet relationship Gauranga, then you must remember the topics of Chota Haridas. Chota Haridas you must, Mahaprabhu speaking, Bairagi, Mahaprabhu speaking, Bairagi huya kare stri shambhasan, dekhite na pari ami tahar badan. They have taken vow to live their life as sannyas, brahmachari. They are in renounce order and they are going to, you know, stri shambhasan. They are going to enjoy with women through their topic passive calm. I cannot forgive them. So outside people can someday, somehow can get excuse. But those who are entering into renounce order and following this kind of false procedure to show their renounce order in front of public, they can never be excused by Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu can never excuse them. Mahaprabhu can never excuse them. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, how I can know? They are taught preaching. You will have to come in front of Mataji's, Pitaji's, everybody. Everybody will have to come, na, for preaching. So Prabhupada told, if you have no enjoying mood for only for the satisfaction of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, for Chaitanya Vani, you can come in front of, you know, public. That doesn't mean you are going to get their association. You are going to give your highest association to them. A sadhu, if going to deliver somebody and going to fall down, if I am going to deliver one Mataji, I myself fall down, then what use? Eh? This is not allowed, actually. So Mahaprabhu, actually in Gauriya Siddhanta, it is that you should avoid enjoying mood. So many people can come in front of me. Mahaprabhu showing this, you know, idealism, to check us, so that they cannot think that Mahaprabhu allow, Mahaprabhu speaking with woman, Mahaprabhu looking at woman. No, Mahaprabhu going to show this example in front of us, so that we must be very careful. That doesn't mean, in course of preaching, I cannot come in front of any Mataji. Thousands of Mataji can come, but I cannot allow them to come separately. Everywhere I announce in Jalandhar, everywhere. If they at all like to put some question, they must come with their husband or brother or temple man or son. I cannot allow them. Allow me come? So it is the teachings of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So I will have to discover how far I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Jashish Sangha Tag, Asas Sangha Tag, E Vaishnava Achar. Mahaprabhu speaking, Bairagi Huya Kare Sri Sambhashan, Dekhite Napari Ami Kahar Badon. They have taken vow to lead their life as Brahmacharya and Sannyasi, and they are going to maintain passive calm inside their heart. How I can excuse them? I cannot see their face. I don't like to see their face. Those who are going to collect money, position, everything, Prabhupada speaking, that God bless me so that I need not see their face the rest of my life. Those who are going to collect money, position, everything, and going to utilize it for their own pratishtha, God bless, Supreme Lord, bless me so that I need not see their face rest of my life. I don't like to see their face. So we will have to understand the heart of Prabhupada, and we will have to detect, we will have to understand how far, how much we are deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada this much. Also, as per this sloka, usually I am speaking, and next day also I can discuss this point, Balavan Adaroja. So long as you are not feeling strong attraction, so long as you are not feeling attraction, full attraction for Guru Vaishnava, so long as you are not going to feel full attraction Guru Vaishnava, all your Shastra Gyan, all your money power, all everything can go to vain, go in vain. Everything can go in vain. Everything. Balavan adaro yasso nasad guru padambuje sutoi rapitasso sasastrair krishne bhakti najayate. You will have to calculate that all your action going to satisfy Krishna or not. You are going to get up at 4 o'clock. If you are not going to satisfy Krishna, what use? You are going to maintain Ekadasi. If you are not going to satisfy Krishna, what use? You are going to recite so much sutra, this, that. If you are going to do all for the satisfaction of Krishna, Bhakti Anukul. Bhakti Anukul Matra, Anukullasya Sankalpa Pratikulla Vivarjanam. You have to calculate it. Then you can understand. Otherwise you can misunderstand Prabhupada all the time speaking this, that. I can explain in details that those who are going to see the whole world in relation of Mahaprabhu, Krishna Chaitanya. That day I was speaking, anything you see, you can see, it is your Guru Pad Padma in different form coming in front of you to test you. In the form of beautiful lady, in the form of Patishtha, or in different form coming in front of you to test you. Gurudev, Guru Ananta, Anantadev Guru, saying Anantaman in countless form can come to test me. To test me, if I am failure, then I can take leave from bhajan. Be careful. Bairagi hoya kare nam, bairagi hoya kare stri sambhashan, dekhite na pari ami tahar badan. That doesn't mean you can hate. Mahaprabhu giving example in Chaitanya Charitamrita, even one model of Mataji, if kept in, you know, in shop where those who are selling shari and, you know, garments, eh? Mahaprabhu speaking, even one statue, model of Mataji is made of wooden. Daru prakriti hare munuropi mon. Daru prakriti hare munuropi mon. Even one Mataji, very nicely decorated, with nice garment and this, that. Munuropi mon. Mahaprabhu speaking, even Munirisi, they can, you know, also feel. attraction. Daru prakriti hare munurabhi mun. And also one thing in this respect I can discuss all in this big area. And one by one if I discuss it will take long time actually. So, balona khaibe ar balona paribe. If you are going to maintain a brahmacharya sannyas, you know, if you, then you have no right to use nice, you know, garment. You have no right. Because it is written by Prabhupada, balona khaibe balona balona paribe, you have no right to take nice thing. And you have no right to take and to put on nice cloth. Why? Because it is against bhajan. But for yukta vairagya, like gopikas, if you do, then there is no problem. With the mood of yukta vairagya, is very typical. With the mood of yukta vairagya, if you do, then there is no problem. But who can point you out that you are doing wrong and right? And if you are taking nice thing, if you are using nice cloth, it is more dangerous than to take nice prasadam. Because you are going to draw the attraction of people through your nice clothes. You are going to draw the attraction of common people with your nice clothes. So to wear nice clothes, to use nice garment, is more dangerous than to take nice prasadam. If you have prasad buddhi, then nice prasadam, bad prasadam, this question cannot come. If you have prasad, prasad means, if prasad going to get control over you, then it is prasad. If you are going to make some estimation, it is nice prasadam, is paramanna, this, that, then it is no more, it is prasadam for you. If prasadam going to get control over your heart, then it is prasadam. I cannot enjoy prasadam. Prasad can enjoy me. This kind of secret siddhanta, if you go on hearing thousands of years, still there is doubt. You can understand the secret heart of Prabhupada. That day I was bound to speak. If we make a comb operation all over the world, this year is, there is doubt that we can get one or two, those who can really understand the heart of Prabhupada. Don't try to misunderstand me. And I can explain this sloka also every day I am speaking. After Harikatha is over, I can in all details I can discuss this point. That where Paramahansa Param, Paramarthapadim, this sloka, and here it is written, Patitodharanekkita Veshajatim. Here is one vital point. Everybody like to misuse this point. They like to point out that my grandson, grandfather, this, that, they took Diksha from Prabhupada, they are Prabhupada Parshad. No! No, not that! False Siddhanta, wrong Siddhanta. No. I can explain this point. That each and everybody not Prabhupada Parshad. Those who wanted to give their life and soul unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada to give full protection to Chaitanya Vani, Siddhanta Vani, they are actually Parshad of Prabhupada. Not everybody. Like Prabhupada wanted to pass one remark. After reading one writing by Srila Siddhar Goswami Maharaj about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, disappearance. Prabhupada, after reading, was bound to pass the remark. I thought after my departure everything can be finished. But now I can keep hope that no. A stream flow of Bhaktivinoda Dara can go. We will have to give our life for Bhaktivinoda Dara, to maintain Bhaktivinoda Dara. We will have to give our life and soul to protect Bhaktivinoda Dara. I know numbers of demons are countless and we are alone. But we should not forget that Balaji Maharaj is there with us. We are not alone. Balaji Maharaj is there with us. So we are not going to fear anybody. We are going to expose your naked picture in front of public to show that you are going to cheat everybody. Paramhamsa varam paramatha patim patito dharane krita besha jatim jati rajagunai pariseva padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam vanchakalpadurvasya kipasindu bhavasya patitanam pavana bhavasya bhyo namo.